Hey guys, and thanks so much for joining me today. Today is day number 2.
Hello guys, it is Sam from the future using my awful ass front facing camera for my phone. Sorry, I just wanted to let you guys know that my camera has shut off on me during the intro and I did not realize until I started editing the video. So I apologize, but I will go ahead and just state that what I was going to say was this is day number 2 of my 100 days of makeup challenge and it's a summary look. This obviously is not, but of course in the video it is. And I missed the part where I did my primer and I go on to eyes and all that good stuff. So I apologize once again. I'll do better next time. Hope you enjoy the video.
I also want to give the eyes a bit of a boost too. So I'm using this Tula Rose Glow and Get It Cooling and Brightening Eyeball. So I'm going to use this on basically all over the eyes. Help waken them up a bit. Give them a little pat. So next, instead of having a heavy on foundation and whatnot, I'm going to use a BB cream. This is one by e.l.f. I'm also going to pair it up with the Lumi Glotion from L'Oreal. I feel like it would complement each other better. This is a thick BB cream, unfortunately. The reason being is because I want some coverage still. I am going to add a bit more to the mix of lotion than I am for the BB cream, just so I do get a boost of a glow. More than coverage, though coverage is something that I want. I'm definitely going for more of a dewy base today. Make sure I get that nice and even everywhere. Definitely seeing the dew. Myself close up and make sure that everything is blended and buffed in to where no streaks, no creasing, all that good stuff. I mean, I'm gonna get creases. I have wrinkles and lines and whatnot, but the streaky part, I think. I think that combination turned out pretty well. What you think? All right, now for the concealer, I do want to brighten up my brighter areas, but I think I'm gonna stay away from the darkening concealer or anything like that, because I wanna keep everything like glowy. So I'm gonna use like a brightening bronzer or something like that. You'll see, going into this Amuse palette, I'm going to take the brightest shade and brighten my under eyes. Brighten up the other areas, like the nose. Five head. Okay. Keep as well, always. Turn a little bit more to the five head. I want to pat it in with my finger. Really warm up that product and get it melted into the foundation. I'm going to be using a lot of cream products today and a lot of liquidy stuff, so we're not done quite yet. I'm going to continue on with the glowy bronzer. This is the Essence Make Me Glow Liquid Bronzer. Yes, it is a little dirty because I have a daughter that does not respect. But this is in the shade Sun in a Bottle, and it comes like this with a little doe foot applicator. And it smells good. Now, same for most of my contouring / bronzing products. I don't like to go first thing on there. I like to put some on my hand like this and then either use my finger or a brush or sponge or whatnot, kind of concentrate it to where I want it to go. This is a liquid bronzer, so I'm not going to concentrate it in one area, kind of like contour. I kind of want to just sun kiss the face, you know? I'm going to take this nice little Real Techniques brush right here. I'm going to just add this glow to my face where I see fit. So a little some right here, a little some around here. So kind of in the areas where I would normally contour, but much more broader. Like I'm bringing it up to the cheeks, all over the forehead, bringing it into my hairline, making sure it's also blended as I go. So not only am I getting those bronzed up points, but I'm also getting the high points too, because normally that's where the sun would hit you. So I'm getting all over the my nose right here, on my brow bone, chin, a little bit right here, getting those apples too. And this color isn't dark whatsoever. It's literally just like a skin color type of bronzer, but it's beautiful. I love it. Now, of course, for deeper complexions, it would definitely be something used as a highlight. All right, and just another thing to add to the face for that glow factor, I'm using this NYX Born to Glow Liquid Illuminator, and I'm adding this only to those high points where I would normally highlight. Right up here. Tip of the nose. And I'm going to bring it up the bridge since I'm not doing any contouring. So just strobing. Hit that cupid's bow like a mofo. And I'm going to hit those temples. Now, last cream product for the face. It doesn't really help with the glow. I guess, I mean, it kind of does, but it's a cream blush. So I want to add that to give my cheeks a little bit of a sun-kissed burn, or a little cutesy little sun-kissed burn. I'm going to use my finger again, kind of get that product nice and warmed up, and apply where I want it. I want to put this basically all over the cheek. It includes my apples down here and up top, up to the temple. And make sure I'm blending as I go, so dispersing that product in all surrounding areas. And now, unfortunately, I got stickiness to the face, so I'm going to add just the slightest amount of powder. Definitely don't want to overdo that. Not with what I'm going on right now. I'm taking a very soft brush, just going to lightly dust this powder, so I don't get rid of all the hard work I did on putting my face through, making it shine, making it glow, turn myself into a disco ball with a hint of diamond. Now, as for the neck, I'm gonna go a little bit more crazy since I didn't add any glow product, just foundation and, you know, glow shim itself. With that being said, it's time to move out to eyes. I will put you guys on pause for a second and be right back while I do one eye. Like I said, very, very simple. Let's get you guys up close and personal, whoops. So you can see what we got going on here. So really all I did for the eye is add some sparkle to it. And I actually sheep my brow today. No, I am not going to tweeze those hairs, as you can clearly see underneath the mascara. Not mascara, but the concealer. But it's a thing. I don't know why, but summer screams shaping brows to me. And wintertime screams more bushy. So of course, I always prime my eyes. Primer is important to me, face and eye. I'm using some Essence I Love Stage. Just getting a little bit, and I am rubbing that all over. Now for the glitter, I actually use an e.l.f. eye glitter. I forgot what they're called exactly, and there's no name. So I have to look this up and put it in the description box. But it comes with a little applicator inside, one of the flat ones. And I just smeared some all over the eye. I didn't go any farther than the lid. Grab a blending brush. This one is also from e.l.f. This is their blending brush. And I bring it upward and out a little bit. Instead of just having it in the lid and being kind of a harsh looking thing, I bring it up and out. So I have glitter basically all over the eye. I don't bring it up to the brow bone though. If I want to add more than I could, personally, I feel like it could use more, but I've only added one to this eye, so I think I'll be fine with it. Now for the under eye, I use the same thing. All I did was I used the edge of the applicator and trace the lash line all the way to the end. Now I'm only going to be wearing mascara, no lashes, so I'm going to give my lashes a bit of a boost. I'm using this long comb, I don't know, it's like Seals Booster XL, little mini that I got, and it's a lash primer. Coating my lashes with that. That's my cat. Girl, I would like to be in my... One second. Mascara choice is Maybelline's Lash Sensational. Alright, and then moving on to the brows. I'm using this Maybelline Wooden Brow Eye Pencil. It's one of those. They don't have the name on here. It's a long name. This is the black one. I'm using this basically to kind of draw in my brows. I'm doing it very lightly, kind of like really hair-like strokes. I'm kind of mapping out where I want it, trying to my best to match the other brow, but it's very rare that ever happens. What I want to do is I want to go over with some brow gel. This is an Ulta brow gel, cute little spoolie applicator that I got. I'm going to try to get my eyebrow hairs go upward, then back down. Now I'm going back to my concealer palette, and I'm using the lightest shade. No, the second to lightest shade. And I'm going to carve out the bottom of my brows. Not really worried about the top spine. Not only will this carve, but this will highlight my brow bone for me. I'm going to pat it out with my finger so that the edge is blended. Still don't look the same, and they never will. So for me personally, nothing screams summer more than a bright, blinding orange lip. I don't know why orange, but it's just the most summer color to me. I mean, there's also yellows and reds and everything like that that can go along with summer as well. But I don't know. It's just orange. Probably because orange is also my favorite color. I don't know. I am going to moisturize my lips first, and I'm going to use some Maybelline Baby Lips. I could just leave it right here because I also feel like this is pretty summery, but I do want to kick it up just one notch, and that is with a lip gloss, and this is from She Glam. This is one of their lipsticks, and is in orange Starburst. I said lipstick. This is their lip glaze in orange Starlight, not Starburst. So pretty. And I think right there might be enough. I'm gonna back you guys up now. It definitely turned out the way that I wanted to. Just cute, glowy skin, cute orange lips, nice simple eyes, brows. I'm really happy how this turned out, and I hope you guys did enjoy the video. I'll be looking forward to continuing on this series for you guys. I am so excited to actually be doing this and going in full-fledged. So hopefully you guys will stay along with me. I do plan on adding some avant-garde, special effects, all that good stuff, gore. So it's going to be a pile of everything. And I'm thinking whenever I go into this again that I'm going to have just a one-time thing. Not one-time thing, but like one thing. Like I'll do beauty, then I'll do another 100 makeup, special effects, avant-garde, all that good stuff. So I'm excited to continue on this journey for you guys. And I hope you're excited too. Thank you so much for being with me, guys. I am out. Goodbye. Love y'all.